Along dear experience, we are going to say a few exam-oriented tricks regarding antibiotic drugs. So, few important points for mechanism of action. Remember, sulfonamide inhibit bacterial folate synthetase, fluoroquinolones inhibit bacterial DNA gyrase, tetracycline bind to 30S ribosome, chloramphenicol bind to 50S ribosome, clindamycin inhibit protein synthesis by binding to 50S ribosome, streptomycin bind to 30S ribosome, and other aminoglycoside bind to both 30 and 50S ribosome. Now, vancomycin, teicoplanin, penicillin, cephalosporin, they inhibit cell wall synthesis, and polymyxin B and colistin form pseudopore in cell membrane. Now remember, chemoprophylaxis for common disorder like cholera, tetracycline, diphtheria, erythromycin, influenza A, amantadine, meningococcal meningitis, sulfadiazine, and pneumonic plaque tetracycline. Now, whenever there is a consumption of antibiotics, we can say over consumption of antibiotics, there is a problem known as resistance. There is an antimicrobial drug resistance. So it's of three type conjugation, which is very important clinically. That's a multiple drug resistance, commonly seen with chloramphenicol and streptomycin. So what happens in conjugation? The physical contact with the bacteria occur. And in transduction, the genes, the genetics will get transferred through bacteriophage. The common is Strep aureus, commonly seen in penicillin, erythromycin, and chloramphenicol. And in transformation, the genetic transfer occurs through environment. The example is penicillin G, commonly seen with pneumococci and Neisseria. Now, pseudomembranous colitis. So, the most common organism in pseudomembranous colitis is Clostridium difficile. The most common antimicrobial implicated here is third generation cephalosporins followed by clindamycin. The treatment of choice for that is metronidazole, and in severe cases, it requires vancomycin. Then drugs having CDK, there's a concentration dependent killing. There's aminoglycosides and fluoroquinolones. TDK, time dependent killing, seen in beta lactams and vancomycin, and prolonged PAE against gram negative bacteria. There's a post antibiotic effect seen with carbamazepines, tetracycline, chloramphenicol, aminoglycosides, fluoroquinolones, and rifampicin. Now, the important points for the tetracyclines, remember you can remember this mnemonic tetracycline. So TET, that's a tetracycline. R, rickettsia or relapsing fever. A, atypical pneumonia. C, for cholera. L, you can remember Lyme disorder. C, chlamydia. L, LGV. I, and inguinal. E, epidemics of plaque. Now tetracycline have few anti-anabolic effects, like you can remember the Kapil Dev. K, kidney failure. All tetracycline are contraindicated except doxycycline. A, anti-anabolic effect. P, photosensitivity, maximum with democlocycline. I, it can cause insipidus, diabetes insipidus, maximum with democlocycline. L, liver toxicity, it can cause hepatic necrosis. D, it affects dentition and bone defect, that's why contraindicated in pregnancy and children below 7 years. E, expired drugs can cause Fanconi syndrome. And V, it can cause vestibular dysfunction, most commonly seen with minocycline. Then, how the renal function is affecting drug. Like few drugs are contraindicated in renal disorder like cephalothene, cephaloridine, nitrofurantoin, nalidixic acid, and tetracyclines, except doxycycline, a very important MCQ. Dose reduction required renal failure is aminoglycosides, amphotericin B, vancomycin, and ethambutol. Note, aspirin, penicillins, and rifampicin do not require dose adjustment in renal disorder. Now, liver function. Drugs contraindicated in liver disorder, that's erythromycin, tetracycline, pyrazinamide, and pefloxacin. And dose reduction required in renal failure are chloramphenicol, isoniazid, rifampicin, and clindamycin. Now, genetic factors. Now, antimicrobials producing hemolysis in G6PD deficient patients are primaquine, chloroquine, quinine, chloramphenicol, nitrofurantoin, fluoroquinolones, dapsone, and sulfonamides. Now, few important point aspirin, antimicrobials secreted in bile. So, penicillins we have in that amphicillin, nepsicillin, cephalosporin we have ceftriaxone, cefoperazone, doxycycline, rifampicin, and erythromycin. So, aspirin, please try to remember all these shortcuts that can be your one-liners. Now, sulfonamides commonly causing rash. So, you can remember for the side effect of sulfonamide rash, that is ABC of rash. A for aplastic anemia, B for bilirubin displacement, that's a conductus, C for crystalluria, R for rash, most common side effect, A for acetylation, S for SLE, that's a systemic lupus erythematosus, and H, hemolysis in G6PD deficient patient. Now, important point for cotrimoxazole, it's a fixed dose combination of sulfa, methoxazole and trimethoprim in a ratio of 5:1. Remember, both drugs, there's a sulfa, methoxazole and trimethoprim has similar half-life and the combination is bactericidal to most pathogens. But due to different availability, more for sulfa, methoxazole, plasma concentration of true drug attain is 20:1. Remember these drugs, cotrimoxazole is a drug of choice for pneumocystosis and nocardiosis. For indication, you can remember Ceftron, S for STD, you can use for chancroid, LGV, E, enteritis, both for E. coli, Shigella, P, PCP, T for typhoid, R for RTI, A for acute uncomplicated UTI, and N for nocardia. Now, the aspirin, this PCP stand for the pneumocystis, xerorrhachae, pneumonia, RTI, respiratory tract infection, and UTI, urinary tract infection. Now, major routes for drug elimination, renal, aminoglycosides, amphotericin B, beta-lactams, quinolones, sulfonamides, and tetracyclines. And hepatic and biliary, you can remember this good shortcut, metabolism can prevent dose adjustment in renal condition. So, M for metronidazole, E for erythromycin, T, ceftriaxone, A, azithromycin, B, O, novobiocin, L for linezolid, I for isoniazid, S for streptogramins, M, moxifloxacin, C, clindamycin, prevent, you can remember, cefoperazone, dose D, that's a doxycycline, adjustment A, amphicillin, I, and amphicillin, renal rifampicin, and C here, chloramphenicol. Then remember, aspirin, metronidazole is a drug of choice for giardiasis, ulcer, pseudomembranous colitis, trichomoniasis, and amoebiasis. Remember the mnemonics Gupta. Drug of choice for Kala-Azar, it's a liposomal amphotericin B. Drug of choice for cutaneous leishmaniasis, that's a sodium stibogluconate. And most commonly drug used for leishmania is sodium stibogluconate. Now, very important topic, aspirin. What are the topical drugs for superficial fungal infection? Includes polyenes, that is a nystatin, used topically for local candida infection and orally for GI fungi. Imidazoles. Various imidazoles are there, commonly used ketoconazole, allyl amines like terbinafine, oxavorols, that is a tavavorol example, then cyclopyrox, olamine, then very important, white film ontamine, that's a benzoic acid, the salicylic acid, then tonafate, then undeclining acid and haloperidol. Then last mnemonic for the day, aspirin, antibiotics contraindicated during pregnancy, remember the word MSAT, that's a metronidazole, chloramphenicol, aminoglycoside, and tetracycline. So, aspirin, that was all for today.